that slogan, a computer on every desk in every home, that comes from 1975. And it did have, at the end, it internally we said running Microsoft software. But outside we always said a computer on every desk in every home. And I think we actually got rid of that as the mantra like, you know, 10 or 12 years ago, because, you know, at least in the rich world, we were on a path to have that take place. And the idea of, you know, tools of empowerment, tools of understanding, tools of creativity and communication, I think we took something on that was a bit more broader. You know, after all, now it's not just one computer. It's a computer in your pocket. It's the deep sensors. It's the way these systems are going to work together with profoundly different UI. You know, it's certainly true that the way people use the web, the way people use Office, you know, they're way short. There's all sorts of capability in there that if you had time to explain it to them, they could get more out of it. And it's surprising how little we've had a breakthrough in terms of how you fully take advantage of software. Even if you look at what people type into search engines, you know, where that's one of the most studied thing in terms of, you know, that's a real-time digital stream that we're pattern matching all again and again, helping them do that in a way that would be most effective, you know, we're not all that great in it. So we'll always have this, you know, frontier of what you could do with software and what we've made easy for lots and lots of people to do. You know, software is going to be more ambitious as we're actually representing things in deep ways. You know, as everyone gets essentially what we'll call the personal agent, you know, it's been talked about for decades and now really is possible, where we see where you're going, we see your calendar, we see your various communications. Some of those communications we can actually, you know, look at the text, look at the speech, try to be helpful to you in your activities. I think we will be more connected, and therefore, you know, if somebody wants to do a task like, you know, find a gift of a certain type, organize a trip of a certain way, that there will be a closer match, that is the gap between what the software could do for them and what most people end up doing, that could be reduced. But, you know, you always make mistakes on these things. When the machine, you know, tries to do the table with numbers, or the dog, you know, comes up and says, oh, you didn't do this thing right, Microsoft Bob style, which is a long time ago, we tried a little personality that was definitely premature. I think it will reemerge, but perhaps with a deep bit more sophistication. You know, we were just ahead of our time, like most of our mistakes. So, you know, it's a research issue to make software better. And, you know, the prize when you do these things is very, very large in a commercial sense.